Hello students and welcome to Education Eternity. So please like the channel, subscribe to it, click on the notification bell. Now today's chapter is sound. Class 10th ICSC, it's sound. So sound is produced when a body vibrates and it reaches us through the vibrations of the particles of the surrounding medium. Thus, sound requires a medium for its propagation. The very most important thing for the propagation of sound is that it requires a medium for its propagation, because without the medium there is no availability of particles, and without the transfer of particles, or collision of particles, or propagation of particles, sound cannot be heard. Now, our ears are very sensitive part of our body, and it has a very limited range, and the range is from 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, and this range is known as our audible range, or range of audibility. Now, the sound which are above 20,000 hertz, they are known as ultrasonic vibrations, whereas the sound, yeah, frequency which is below 20 hertz is called the infrasonic. But both the ultrasonic and infrasonic are inaudible to humans, but they both travel in a medium with the same speed as that of audible sound. Now, when a sound wave travels in a medium, the maximum displacement of the particle of medium on either side of its mean position is called the amplitude of the wave. The time taken by the particle of the medium to complete its one vibration is known as the time period. The number of vibrations made by the particles of the medium in 1 second is known as its frequency. The frequency of a wave is same as that frequency of the source which is producing it. Frequency of the wave will be same to the frequency of the source which is producing it. The distance traveled by a wave in one time period of vibration is called wavelength, and wavelength is denoted by lambda. And the distance traveled by the wave in 1 second is called the wave velocity. And we have a relation, that is V equal to F lambda, and F will be equal to 1 by T, that is frequency will be reciprocal of time period. Now, the sound waves necessarily require a medium for their propagation. I told you this earlier. The transfer of energy waves is through vibration of medium particles about their mean position. So when the medium particles vibrate, there is a change of kinetic energy into potential energy and vice versa. So sound waves are also called elastic or mechanical waves. So sound waves are also known as mechanical waves. Now you know the reason why. Because when the particles of that medium vibrate, there is a change of kinetic energy into potential energy, and there is a vice versa, that is potential to kinetic. Now there are two types of mechanical waves. The first is the longitudinal waves, and the second one is the transverse wave. Now, if the vibration of particles are along the direction of propagation of the wave, so it forms the compression and the rarefactions. So this wave is known as longitudinal wave. What is transverse wave? If the medium of particle vibrate normal to the direction of propagation of the wave, forming crest and troughs, this is known as transverse wave. Now, you know that we have some differences between light waves and sound waves. What are these differences? The light waves are electromagnetic waves, whereas the sound waves are mechanical waves. The light waves can travel in vacuum, but the sound waves requires a medium for its propagation. The waves, light waves are transverse, but the sound waves are longitudinal as well as transverse. Now, reflection of sound waves. Sound waves, just like any other wave, when strike a hard surface, such as a boundary of another medium, it returns back in the same medium, obeying the law of reflection. That is, the angle of reflection is equal to the angle of incidence. The second one is the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal all lie at the same point of incidence. That is, all lie in a same plane. Now, the return of sound wave on striking the surface and then back to the same medium is known as reflection of the sound wave. The only requirement for the reflection of sound wave is that the size of the reflecting surface must be bigger than the wavelength of sound waves. Now we have echo. What is echo? Production and generation of echo. So if a person stands at some distance from a wall or a hillside and produces a sharp sound, he hears two distant sounds. Pehli, the original sound which is heard almost instantaneously, and the sound heard after reflection from a wall or hillside, and this sound is known as echo. So what is echo? The sound heard after reflection from a distant obstacle such as cliff, hillside, wall of a building after original sound has ceased is called an echo. Now what is condition for hearing an echo? An echo is heard only if the distance of the person producing sound from the rigid obstacle is long enough to allow the reflected sound to reach the person at least 0.1 second after the original sound is heard. And we take a distance d and a time t. So when you are calculating the total distance, the total distance becomes 2d. So 2d by v. And if we are putting the time, our time should be 0.1 seconds and the V is 340 meter per second, then the minimum distance which is required to hear the echo is 17 meter. Now, the second one is minimum distance. I have told you it must be 17 meter. The size of reflector must be large enough as compared to the wavelength of sound wave. And third, the intensity of sound should be such that the reflected sound reaching the ear is sufficiently intense to audible, because jab travel hota hai to matlab kuch energy khatam hoti rehti hai, sound dheeri hoti rehti hai. Agar bahut dheere hi hoga to reflect hoke back to aayegi, lekin aapke kaan tak pahunchte vaste khatam ho chuki hai, isliye aapko sunai nahi dega. Now what are the uses of echoes ya echoes? First, they can travel undeviated through a long distance. They can be confined to a narrow beam and they are not easily absorbed in a medium. Now, dolphins, bats and fishermen also use echoes. How? Dolphins detect their enemy and obstacle by emitting the ultrasonic waves and hearing their echo. They use ultrasonic waves for hunting their prey. And how does a fisherman sends a pulse of ultrasonic waves from a source into the sea and receives the waves reflected from the shoal of a fish in a detector. The total time t to the to and fro journey of the wave is recorded. The distance d of a fish is then calculated using the relation d equal to v into t by 2, where v is nearly 400 meter per second. Now, the next one is sonar. So, what is sonar? Basically, sonar stands for sound navigation and ranging. So, principle of sonar, in which ultrasonic waves are sent in all directions from the ship. These waves are received after reflection from an obstacle such as enemy submarine, or iceberg, or sunken ship, etc. So, to find the distance of an obstacle from a ship, the time travel t between the instant when the waves are sent and instant when the waves are received, our reflection from the obstacle is measured. Again, the distance is calculated by the formula d equal to v into t by 2. The depth of a sea can also be found by this method. The process is then called echo depth sounding. So sonar ka use yahi hota hai ki log matlab आइसबर्ग से खुद को बचाने के लिए या किसी एनिमी की सबमरीन से या फिर मतलब कोई पुरानी नाव मतलब कुछ कोई बड़ी सी शिप डूब चुकी है उसको पता करने के लिए, तो इन सब चीज़ों के लिए लोग सोनार का यूज़ करते हैं. Now, echo can be used in medical field, such as ultrasonic waves is used for imaging the human organs, जैसे gall bladder, uterus, womb, इसको ultrasonography भी हम लोग कहते हैं। तो इस तरीके से अब हम लोग बात करने वाले हैं natural vibrations की। natural vibrations क्या होते हैं? The periodic vibrations of a body in the absence of any external force on it are known as natural or free or undamped vibrations. तो जो खुद से होते हैं, कोई एक्सटर्नल फोर्स नहीं लगता है, वो हमारी नेचुरल वाइब्रेशंस होती हैं। डैम्प्ड वाइब्रेशंस क्या होते हैं? द पीरियोडिक वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ अ बॉडी ऑफ डिक्रीजिंग एम्पलीट्यूड इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ अ रेजिस्टिव फोर्स आर कॉल्ड डैम्प्ड वाइब्रेशंस। मतलब डिक्रीजिंग एम्पलीट्यूड है, वो घटता रहेगा, तो ये हमारे डैम्प्ड वाइब्रेशंस होते हैं। फोर्स्ड वाइब्रेशंस क्या होते हैं? द वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ अ बॉडी विच टेक्स प्लेस अंडर इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ एन एक्सटर्नल पीरियोडिक फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन इट इज नोन एज अ फोर्स्ड वाइब्रेशन। इसके बाद रेजोनेंस, एक और हमारा स्पेशल केस है फोर्स वाइब्रेशन का, रेजोनेंस। सो रेजोनेंस इज अ स्पेशल केस ऑफ फोर्स वाइब्रेशन व्हेन द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ एन एक्सटर्नली अप्लाइड पीरियोडिक फोर्स ऑन अ बॉडी इज इक्वल टू इट्स नेचुरल फ्रीक्वेंसी द बॉडी रेडिली बिगिन्स टू वाइब्रेट विद एन इंक्रीज्ड एम्पलीट्यूड दिस फिनोमेना इज नोन एज रेजोनेंस एंड द वाइब्रेशंस ऑफ लार्ज एम्पलीट्यूड आर नोन एज द रेजोनेंट वाइब्रेंट्स या रेजोनेंट वाइब्रेशंस। Now, what is the condition for resonance? Resonance occurs only when the frequency of the applied force is exactly equal to the natural frequency of the vibrating body and the applied force causes vibration in the body. So, ये होता है। जैसे tuning force का जो experiment है, ये हमारा resonance में काफ़ी अच्छे से help कर सकता है। इसके बाद characteristics of sound, यहाँ पे हम लोग बात करेंगे लाउडनेस, पिच और क्वालिटी। लाउडनेस क्या होती है? लाउडनेस इज़ द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक बाय वर्चू ऑफ विच अ लाउड साउंड कैन बी डिस्टिंग्विश्ड फ्रॉम ए फेंट वन बोथ हैविंग सेम पिच एंड क्वालिटी। अगर पिच सेम है, क्वालिटी सेम है, तो लाउडनेस के हिसाब से हम लोग साउंड को डिफाइन कर सकते हैं। एंड लाउडनेस ऑफ अ साउंड डिपेंड्स ऑन द एम्पलीट्यूड ऑफ द वेव। नाउ The next one is pitch. Pitch is that characteristic of sound by which an acute note can be distinguished from a grave or flat one. Yeah, from a flat note. Now, pitch of a note depends on its frequency. The third one is quality or timbre. So, quality or timbre of a sound is that characteristic which distinguish the two sounds of the same loudness and same pitch. अगर loudness भी बराबर है, pitch भी बराबर है, लेकिन यहाँ पे quality या timbre एक ऐसी चीज़ होती है जो इसको differ कर देगा। And the quality of a musical sound depends on the wave form. यह होता है। इसके अलावा music or noise. Music क्या है? It is a regular smooth and it is pleasant to our ears. Noise है, harsh होती है, discordant होती है, and it is unpleasant to our ears. Music is produced by vibrations which are periodic. Noise is produced by irregular successions of disturbances. The wave form in music is regular, whereas the wave form in noise is irregular. The sound level which is low, that is between 10 to 30 dB, it is known as music, whereas the sound level which is high, which is above 120 dB decibels, it is noise. So that's it, friends, your chapter is over. Hope you enjoyed this video and you have understood the chapter. So like the video, subscribe to the channel, click on the notification bell. If you have any queries, ask in the comment section, and thank you, students.